Hello, my friends all over the world, wherever you are. William Poloniak here again from Whole Health Foundation. Recently, I was asked by a housewife what to do when the power cord on her juicer was broken, and I'm going to show you what to do. There are two ways you can do it. The simple way is with wire nuts, and the more complicated way is to solder the wire together. Let's take a closer look. This video clip shows what happened to one power cord on an Owok juicer, and as you can see, it's broken here. The first thing we need to do is take this grommet out, pinch it with a channel lock pliers or another method, pull the power cord out, and we're going to have to cut the power cord here, and then on the power cord side, we're going to cut it here, expose the wires, and I'm going to show you in the next clip what to do. Well, here are the tools you're going to need to splice a broken wire together. In the case of the housewife, somehow there was a short in the wire and it got fried. The first thing you're going to need to do is cut the wire, and then with a utility knife or any method that is good for you, cut off the outer insulation, as I'm doing here. Now, inside there are some fibers that keep the cord from stretching. So what we're going to do is cut those off. I'm going to use the scissors. The next step is to get the proper gauge, which in this case is 14 gauge, and strip about a half an inch off each wire, as I'm doing here. And you do that on the juicer side and the power cord that comes out of the wall side. Now, the more difficult way would be first to get some shrink wrap. This is shrink wrap, and it shrinks when you apply heat. And what you would do would be to put the shrink wrap on one end of the wire first, like that, and then with a soldering gun, place the wires together, solder them, and once it's soldered, move the shrink wrap over the whole cord, and with some heat from a heat gun, a hair dryer, or even from the soldering tool, shrink the wrap. Now, what we're going to do is the simple method with what's called wire nuts. Put the white wire to the white wire, twist it a little bit, put the wire nut on until it's nice and snug, like that. Green to green. Another wire nut, and then black to black. Now, what I would suggest would be to put all of the repaired wires inside the sheet metal, like that, and then with the grommet that comes on the power cord on the juicer, going to have to crimp that on tightly with a pair of pliers, and then you're going to push that in. Now, let me see if I can demonstrate how to do that. So with it, and then force it in to the hole as I'm doing here. May not be this easy when you do it, but there's the fix. Now, I'm just simulating this, and inside you see you will have the wire nuts, and just make sure they're on tightly and they're not exposed to the outside, and only you will know. I hope you like what you've seen, and if you do, please tell a friend, And if you'd like to call me, my phone number is 760-753-0321. My email address is developtrust@cox.net. And my webpage is wholehealthfound.com. I hope you like what you've seen. See you in the next video.